Hi friends, myself Darshana Sarla here on behalf of Dress My Craft, and today I'll be showing you all how to create this beautiful, cute, dainty and delicate hair comb using the shrink print frosted glass sheets. So let's get started. To create this beautiful hair comb, I have used the flower making cutting dies. That is, create a flower die. It's a set of 10 dies. So there are around total 8 sizes of these flower petals. So to begin with, I have used the biggest size 1 piece, the second size 1 piece, the third size I have used 2 pieces, and for the fourth size I have used 2 pieces. And the leaves, the 3 petal leaves are around 7 to 8 approximately, and the small 2 petal leaves are also around 7 to 8. We may not use them all, but we would create some extra so that while arrangement we do not fall in short of it. Apart from these die cutouts from the shrink print frosted glass sheets, we will also require the soft pastels. These are soft pastels from Mungyo. This is the embossing pad. These are the glues which I have used. So this is B6000, you can also use E6000. This is RTV silicone rubber gel. And we also require the heat tool, which is a very important one. We also require these embossing tools, the small size, the medium size. We require the heat resistant tweezers, the hand punches of all the 3 sizes, that is 1/16, 1/8 and 1/4. We also require the corner punch. These are the corner punches from Dress My Craft, and this is the tiny corner punch also from Dress My Craft. You can use any one of this. We need the base hair combs. We also need the leftover shrink print frosted sheet, 1/2 inch strip, a little bit longer than the required length of the hair comb, and we require these diamond studs. These diamond studs are available with Dress My Craft, and we need a small scissor. So let's get started creating this very beautiful and a wonderful hair comb. Once we are ready with the die cutouts, we will first do the coloring part. So let's do coloring with the soft pastels on the frosted side. So I'll take first a baby pink, and then in the center I'll be using a violet shade. So in the beginning, you take the baby pink, rub on a little bit of baby pink shade over the frosted side and rub it. So this makes it help spread uniformly all over. Once you finish spreading the color uniformly all over, it becomes uniform. It is very important to make sure that the color placed is uniform, or else the patches would show once you have finished with your embossing. Thereafter, we need a little bit of a violet color in the center. Just rotate a small bit of our color in the center and try to blend it, bring it out on all the 5 petals almost midway, making sure that the 2 colors blend in so well that you wouldn't hardly come to know from where the pink and the purple have merged in. Because if there are any patches, they are surely going to show once you are going to emboss it. So exactly in the same manner, we have to complete coloring all the flower petals. And now I'll show you how to color the leaves. So here is a 3 petal leaf and here is a 2 petal leaf. So for the leaf, you can take any 2 shades, or you can also take any 1 shade. So let's take a lighter green, and maybe we can take a little bit of a darker green. So first of all, let me give 1 base coat to the green. This color is a little dark, so I will use it very lightly and gently, and the colors do tone up. They do darken once you have finished with your embossing. So please be careful when you are placing your colors. Let them be as light as possible. So this is 1 single coat of the light shade, and to give a darker shade, I won't rub it. In fact, I will take it on my fingers a little bit, and I will just apply it a little bit on the tips. Very little of the darker green on the tips, and make sure that you blend it very well. So this is how you finish coloring all the leaves, and once we finish coloring all the petals, we will move on to the embossing. Once we have finished with the coloring techniques, now it's a time to go to the most interesting thing, that is the embossing. So before embossing, we need to punch holes in the center so that we can hold the flower petals in its place, and in case if you want to use these as your danglers or your beads, these holes in the center will really help you out. So taking the smallest size of the hand punch and taking the smallest size of the flower petals, I'll punch a hole right in the center here like this. So these are hand punches and this is the 1/16 size. They are super soft and super easy to use. I'll be using the same size of the hand punch even for the second size of the flower, that is a small size of the flower. Once we have done this too, I will take the medium size, that is 1/4, 1/8, and I'll be punching this right in the center here. For the bigger flower petal, I will be using the bigger size. The most important reason behind this is, in case if you shrink, when you shrink, the flower petals become small and at the same time the holes also shrink. So if you are going to use the smaller hole for the bigger flower, the holes might seal up. So it is very important to select the correct size of the hole punch for the correct size of the flower petal. Smaller the size of the flower petal, smaller the size of the flower hand punch. Bigger the size of the petals, the bigger the size of the hand punches. We'll be now using the ceramic tip tweezers. These tweezers will really not burn your fingers and they will not heat up. So it becomes very easier for you to do continuously a longer time of work. Now we also require the heat embossing tools. Keep the shiny side of the frosted glass sheet upwards and place your tweezer right in the center. At the same time, we also require the small ball tool and the medium ball tool. So let's keep the ball tools handy for embossing. This is the embossing pad. To know more details about all these products, you can watch the first tutorial in which we have given detailed brief introduction to all the basic tools and all the basic supplies. I'll put on the heat tool and I'll make sure that I rotate the heat tool all around uniformly to make sure that all the petals get uniform heat and they'll curl up together at the same time. And now the magic begins. So once you put in the heat, make sure that the distance is around 6 inches up, and very soon you will see the petals will start curling, the petals will start wobbling, and they will, you know, take an uneven shape. Do not worry. Heat until you go back, until the petals go back to its original shape. So that is a real time when you will stop the heat tool. You will lift the tweezer from the center and we will be using the ball tool, placing it right in the center. This is the medium size of the ball tool, and curl the tips of the petal. So once you are curling the tips of the petal, it adds some dimension to the flower, it adds some kind of a depth to the flower, and it makes the flower look all the more beautiful and all the more natural. This has to be done very quick because within very few seconds the shrink ring starts hardening. So this is how we have been able to create a wonderful cupped flower. This was the biggest size. We'll be doing the same thing to the second size as well. Keeping the frosted, the glossy side upwards, placing the tweezer right in the center, putting on the heat tool, rotating around all the sides, making sure that you have uniform heat all over, and you will see the petals start wobbling and the petals will start shrinking, and that's so beautiful to see, this beautiful effect of the shrink ring frosted sheet. And can you see how subtle the colors look, how soft the frosted sheet looks? And immediately place a ball tool right in the center, press it on the embossing foam pad, and the tips of the petals you have to curl. So by curling the tips of the petal, by bending the tips of the petal, you get a good dimension to your flower. So this is how pretty this look. In case if you find you're unhappy and dissatisfied with the shape, you can always reheat it. Reheating will not shrink it too much, but yes, it will give you all the more longer time to shape it. This is the third size, keeping the glossy side up. Excuse me. Rotate the heat tool all around and you can see the petals wobbling, and that's the beautiful magic of the shrink ring frosted sheets. Remove this out and I take the small size of the ball tool, press it right in the center, and you get very beautiful cute tiny flower from this. It really looks so damn pretty. It is so cute, and it just within minutes you can create beautiful flowers, so soft, so delicate. Here you go. So now here is the third size, and thereafter we come to the last and the smallest size, that is the fourth size of the petal. So make sure that you rotate your heat tool all over, giving a uniform heat, and within few seconds you will see the petals start wobbling, the petals start curling. You can reheat it, the petals will start turning. So now you take the small size of the ball tool, place it down here and press the tips of the petal. I will reheat this petal so that I get a good shape. Perfect. So now I'll be able to create a beautiful shape from this. And can you see, the second time when I heated it, it has become all the more softer, it has become all the more easy to bend, and it will not dry that fast, it will not cool down very fast, it will give you some good enough time to shape it. So this is how we have been able to create the fourth size. And the most important part here is, you can see the size of the holes. This is the bigger punch, it has given you a bigger hole. This is the medium punch, it has given you a medium size of the hole. This is a smaller punch, it has given you a smaller size of the hole. So you can see the three different sizes, and that they do not seal. That is the most important part by using the perfect size of the hand punches. And now we move on to embossing the leaves. The most interesting part of the leaves is that you have to first hold them in the tweezers and thereafter you heat it. So beautiful, so simple and so delicate are the leaves. And immediately take the ball tool and press it down on each leaf, and you will be able to see beautiful cupped shape of the leaves. They just look so cute and so delicate. They just look amazing. And here the two petal leaf, again the shiny side is up, and you heat it. Very soon you see the petals start shrinking and they look so pretty cute. So we also have the two petal leaf. The stem can be curved or the stem can be straight, that depends upon your requirement. And now we move on to the most exciting part, that is the final arrangement. Now to get started with the final arrangement, the first thing that we need is the hair comb base. We need the leftover strips from the shrink ring frosted sheets. We don't throw them, we keep them so that you can use it anytime on any basis. So anyway, you don't have any support on any kind of accessories, you can use them as your support system. So keeping this on the hair comb, and I'll be cutting a little extra than the base of the comb, so you can cut it here. Once you finish cutting, you can use the corner punch. The corner punch can be 4 mm, this small, or you can even use this tiny corner punch. Any one corner punch you can use. Place this in the corner here and punch it. It is so easy to punch, and this gives you a very beautiful and a neat finish to the shape. So this is a very easy way of using the corner punch and giving a nice and a neat look. Then this is how I have pasted it here. So for sticking, you can either use B6000 or you can use RTV silicone rubber gel. So if you are using the E6000, you can simply put in a few drops of the glue throughout and leave it to dry for at least 1-1.5 hours. So this is like, you know, it is a liquid glue, it will take some time to dry. Make sure you cap them well. keeping the frosted side at the base and keeping the glossy side up. So this is how you stick it and you leave it to dry. Once this is dry, it's ready for doing the final arrangement. You just need to hold it for a few seconds till it is semi-dry. So we already have a dry one ready for you and we will do the final arrangement over it. So once this has dried, your base is ready for final arrangement. For the final arrangement, again you can either use B6000 or you can use the RTV silicone rubber adhesive. So the both, one is a solid glue and one is a liquid glue. With this we need to be a little careful not to use too much so that it doesn't show shabby on the sides. So we'll take it a very little with the help of the toothpick. I'm taking the bigger flower first and I'll place this very little in the center. And I'll place this flower petal in the center here. And along with that, I have a second size of the flower as well. I'll take this too. And I'll place this flower petal here. Now, I take very little of the glue. I have the third size, two pieces. So one goes on the left and the other one goes on the right. Yeah. Take the glue as much you require, don't take too much. And you take very little here for the tiny flower. So you can do this small jobs using your tweezer. That will really give you a good support. Very little glue on the back here. Hold this with the help of your tweezer and lift the petal up a little bit up and place this flower down here. So this is where your base is already ready. Now we need to add in the leaves. I have prepared the leaves and here this is a three petal leaf. So what you will do is take the leaf, take very little gel at the bottom and first put the bigger leaf right in the center. Don't take too much, it will look too messy. The lesser it is, the better it is. And you can have one more here in between and try to push it in. This is another one, three petals. So I will place it down here. This is optional, the leaves. If you like the brew, if you like the hair clip, just like, you know, with the flowers, you can leave them with the flowers. If you like the hair clip along with the leaves, you can leave them like that. So it's all your personal choice, and the best part is you can customize this as per the requirement of your clients, as per the requirement of your students. So now I will go ahead with the tinier leaves. You take this, you take very little of the gel and place it down here. You take this, take very little of the gel and you can place it here. I'll add one more leaf here. We had prepared around 7 to 8 extra leaves. So while arrangement, sometimes you may need a less, you may need a more. It all depends. I can have one tiny one here to fill up that gap. There is a gap here. So you can fill up this small little gap with this. How pretty and how delicate does this look? It is looking so damn cute, so damn pretty. Now to add in some more sparkle to this, to add in some more spark to this, I will be adding in these diamond studs. These diamond studs are available with Dress My Craft for all the products. We have mentioned the links below. You all can click on the links below and you all can check down the list of the products. So this is a bigger size. This is a medium size Let's place and check which one looks good. Oh, this one looks good perfectly well here. Let's check the bigger one. Oh, that too looks damn perfect. So you can also stick it with the silicone, or you can also stick it with B6000. Amazing. Gorgeous. These add a lot of spark to the flowers. Need to clean the tip of the tweezer. It has become a little gluey, so maybe you can do this at regular intervals. Hose out very little and place it right in the center here. One more bigger one, and then we go on to the smaller size for the side tiny flowers. And you place this here. You can also add pearls to the center. One and two. So depending upon the size of the flower, you can select the size of the diamonds. Gorgeous. These look amazing. Okay. Leave this for at least 3 to 4 hours to dry. Do not fidget with it, although it dries within 35 minutes to 40 minutes. But it is good to give it an extra drying time so that it becomes all the more stronger. Since the silicone gel lumps we have put in, you know, a little bit of a thicker quantity, the outer area may dry faster, but the inner center of the silicone gel may take some time to dry. I'm sure you all have enjoyed this tutorial. Hoping for you all to make them and give them to all your near and dear ones. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching the tutorial. Thanks once again.